Green Tree Productions is proud to present Duncanville Weekly News. It's the good news just for the city of champions, Duncanville, Texas. And now, here's your host, John Thompson.
Hello, world, America, Texas, and Duncanville, and welcome to this edition of Duncanville Weekly News for the second week of September 2017. Glad you're logged on and watching. Well, on this show, it's, once again, mostly Panther football as the DHS Panthers are rolling. And we're going to get to the highlights of them right after this.
On Saturday evening, September the 30th, at the Hilton Garden Inn this year, the Duncanville Chamber of Commerce will hold their annual event, this year called Rocking the Past and Rolling the Future. It's from 6 to 10 p.m. with music and dancing by the Big City Music Review. There'll be live auctions during the band intermission with raffle tickets and big spender tickets available, and you don't need to be present to win. This year, former chairman of the board of directors will be recognized, and hey, that's me. For complete information and reservations, go to DuncanvilleChamber.org or call 972-780-4990. See you there.
It's Texas. It's fall. It's high school football time in Duncanville. And the Panthers Den Show on Duncanville Weekly News with highlights of last week's Panther football game and a preview of this week's game.
The Panthers Den is sponsored by the Wolverton Company. Leon Miller Commercial Properties is a proud sponsor. Benjamin Franklin Plumbing. By
James Memorial Chapel. The Pope Financial Group of Raymond James and Associates. Ben Franklin Pharmacy and Kitchens Deli.
By Singla Dental.
By Brett Oliver's Farmers Insurance Agency.
Duncanville Noon Line's annual Barbecue and Blues Festival this year on October 13th and 14th.
And now, here's John with all the DHS Panthers football game highlights.
Hello, Duncanville football fans, and welcome back to the Panthers Den Show. Well, the Panthers had their home opener on Friday night, and here's what happened. It's the home opener for the Panthers this year against Arlington Sam Houston, whom they beat last year. The Texans won their game last week against North Mesquite, so they're also 1-0 on the season. Captains for the Panthers this week are Keyshawn Johnson, Caleb Calcutt, Terrence Newman, and Marcus Mosley. They obviously flipped this week, and we think the Panthers won the toss and deferred, but with no microphone on the officials in Duncanville, who knows, but the Texans will receive. Josh kicks it to the 13, and the Texan returner goes out of bounds untouched at his 18-yard line, and we're underway on plays like this by Gerald Bowie and this by Terrence Newman. The teams swapped a couple of punts in a rather slow-starting offensive game, but half of that is fixing to change. At the Panther 38, quarterback Jaquaden Jackson goes for 11 yards, and then Keelan Elder goes for a tough 7 yards. Jaquaden, 12 yards, and then 9 more on a pass to Guy Smith to the red zone. Then at the Sam Houston 7, Jaquaden, with a good block from Keelan, takes it to the house. Josh converts the point after, So with 1:23 left in the first quarter, the Panthers lead 7-0. After the ensuing kickoff, one of the Texans' plays that netted him the most yardage on the evening was this. The Sam Houston running back falls down in the backfield, and Blake Thomas and Marcus Mosley didn't see it, so they make sure he's down, pop him. And when he gives him a shove back, the Panthers are assessed a 15-yard penalty. And as usual, bad calls are questioned by Coach Samples, and he lets the officials know that that was not the right call. It all kind of evens out because on the next play, James Johnson intercepts to complete the first quarter with the Panthers having the only score.
James Memorial Chapel is the only family-owned funeral home in Duncanville and is proud to offer caring and dedicated services from familiar friends. Rick James and his family, the owners of James Memorial Chapel and Funeral Home, have served Duncanville area families in their time of loss since 1998. A beautiful and spacious chapel is offered, and James serves all cemeteries. When it comes to finding people you can trust in a time of need, you can turn to James Memorial Chapel. No one else knows families better. 811 South Cockrell Hill in Duncanville.
A longtime sponsor of the Panthers Den Show on Duncanville Weekly News is Benjamin Franklin Plumbing, your punctual plumber. Rick and Jamie have been serving the plumbing needs for the Duncanville area since 1984. Remember, their slogan is, "If there's any delay, it's you we pay." Make an appointment and be confident that they will be there on time. Call 972-298-6054 and see for yourself. That's Benjamin Franklin Plumbing.
On the first play of the second quarter, Keelan goes for 33 yards but gets stripped of the ball, and the Texans recover at their own 1 yard line. After a couple of punt exchanges, Marcus makes a sack. This forces another Texan punt, and on first and 10 at the Panther 38, Trey passes to JaQuinton for 38 yards to the Texan 24-yard line. A couple of plays later, it's Trey to Jamil Hamilton for the touchdown. Here's another angle. And Josh's PAT takes it to halftime with the Panthers leading 14-0.
Leon Miller Commercial Properties is a proud sponsor of the Panthers Den Show on Duncanville Weekly News, as he enjoys helping to promote our DHS athletes as no one else does. Leon owns office and retail space in the heart of Duncanville on Main Street. If you are looking for convenient, accessible, and well-kept space for rent, call Leon at 972-709-7181. He will fix you up. Singla Dental, your hometown dental office, is a proud sponsor of our DHS athletes in the Panthers Den on Duncanville Weekly News. Singla Dental offers convenient, extended hours, and same-day appointments are available. Located at 541 West Wheatland, with a website of www.singladental.com. And telephone number is 972-298-4677.
The Panthers took the second half opening kickoff, and with second and five from their own 21-yard line, took only three plays to get to more pay dirt. First, JaQuinton gets nine and takes a helmet to the helmet hit. No penalty, of course. Oh, well, give it to Keelan 23 yards to the Texan 47-yard line. Then Jaquindon goes almost untouched those final 47 yards to the end zone. Here's another angle. Josh converts the PAT, and with less than a minute gone in the third quarter, it's 21-0, Panthers. On second down, after the ensuing Panther kickoff, Marcus gets to the quarterback and causes a fumble, and Terrence recovers at the Sam Houston 18-yard line. And then it's Keelan time again for 8-1. And from there, Josh missed the extra point, so with a little more than 4 minutes gone in the third quarter, it's now 27-0, Panthers. After the kickoff, because of plays like this, a sack by Keyshawn, Blake Thomas, and Charleston Craddock Jackson, Sam Houston punted back to the Panthers, but Josh had to punt back to the Texans, and on their 31-yard line, they fumble again, and in a crowd, but we spot it. Xavier Frazier comes away with the recovery. And then a few plays later, Jaquindon keeps around the left side to pay dirt. Josh adds the PAT, and it's 34-0, Panthers, after three quarters of play.
The 2017 Smokin' Blues and Barbecue Festival, October 13th and 14th at Armstrong Park in Duncanville. Friday night has the All-Star Charity Blues Jam. Saturday's lineup includes the Straight Street Blues Band, Andrew Jr. Boy and Carrie Levi Jones, Larry Lampkin, and Michael Lee in the Wartime Limousine. KCBS Barbecue Cook-Off, food vendors, arts and crafts, custom car show, and kids activities. The Smokin' Blues and Barbecue Festival, Friday and Saturday, October 13th and 14th in Duncanville's Armstrong Park. Smokin' BluesBarbecueFest.com.
The Panthers Den is sponsored by the Wolverton Company, serving the Duncanville, Southwest Dallas area for over 78 years. Wolverton has been a proud sponsor of Duncanville Weekly News since their day one in 1991. From HW to Thomas to Keith and Matthew, Wolverton provides the best heating and air conditioning service there is. Call them at 972-296-COOL. That's 972-296-2665.
The Texans have first and 10 at their 31-yard line and run this play, but the runner is nailed by Keyshawn on the line, and the ball is picked up by Gabe Blanton and taken to the house. Here's a different angle. Keyshawn let him have it. Josh's PAT made it 41-0, 7 seconds into the fourth quarter. After the ensuing Panther kickoff, the Texans punted back to the Panthers, and they have third and 5 at the Sam Houston 34, and Jaquindon passes over to Ezekiel Lang for 17 yards to the 17. Then Warren Calhoun finishes the drive, getting a good block from Guy Smith, taking it home. The Josh PAT made it 48-0 with 5.5 minutes still to go. And both teams are ready to call it a night, running very conservative clock running plays. And it's over. Final, Panthers 48 and the Arlington Sam Houston Texans 0. The Panthers are now 2-0 on the season and moving up in the rankings. Each show we have a play of the week. And in the Arlington Sam Houston game, it happened early in the fourth quarter when Duncanville, already leading 34-0, Keyshawn Johnson hits the Texans runner, causing a fumble that's picked up by Gabe Blanton, who takes it to the house, rendering this game as decided. And that's why it's the play of the week.
The play of the week is brought to us by the Pope Financial Group of Raymond James and Associates. See John at 222 East Wheatland Road or call 972-780-0533 for your investment needs.
Also, we have a hit of the week. And last Friday night, it happened early in the third quarter against Arlington Sam Houston when leading 27-0. This hit by Keyshawn Johnson, Blake Thomas, and Charleston Craddock Jackson sacked the quarterback, calling for another Texan punt. And that's why it's the hit of the week.
The hit of the week is brought to us by Ben Franklin Apothecary, located at 302 North Main Street in the heart of downtown Duncanville. Shop for unique gifts, take care of any pharmaceutical needs, or enjoy lunch at Kitchen's Deli Sandwich Shop. Call 972-298-1147 or visit online for more information.
So the Panthers are 2-0, and here's what's next. This Friday night at 7:30 at our Panther Stadium versus Dallas Skyline. Of course, that's Coach Sample's former school, a team that we beat last year. 7:30, Panther Stadium. As we close, last Thursday night, the Chamber of Commerce had an event which is becoming a tradition in Duncanville, and it's called the Remembrance. And as we close, let's see some highlights from that event, and we'll see you back here September the 19th.
It's important to remember the men who fought to help because they inspire us to continue on, because we know that disasters come.
Something that's close to my heart. You know, I've got a brother who was in the fire service. He's retired now. But I know how close-knit our first responders, our police, and our firefighters are. And I've said it then, and I'll say it again. It's a tragedy that it took something that horrific to make us recognize and appreciate our first responders. We started Bill Lair and called them Duncanville's Navy Heroes because they put their life on the line every day. But it took something as tragic as 9/11 for us to really realize what we have in our first responders each day and in our military. As we've done in years past, you've got a program, you see the names. I won't be back up here introducing everyone. I think that takes away from the program. When I leave here, we're going to show a video. One more. It's the Alan Jackson. It's something I'm going to show every year, I think. It's where were you that September morning?
Those words are written, as he died to make men holy, let us live to make men free. Essentially, in 160 years, somehow, subtly, we've gone from self-sacrifice to self-preservation. And what we saw and what we remember from those days, from that dark day in Dallas, from Charlottesville, from every other trouble-filled place, from Houston, next week from Miami, is that there are people who are willing to join in the rising. There are people who are willing to go up in those smoky stairwells. There are people up there who are willing to to forget about everything the world counts as success or as riches or as acclaim or renown, and simply go with faith, hope, and love.